way, is to remember that this is Obamacare in action. The VA hospitals are being run under similar rules to Obamacare. It is government medicine. It is government controlled. It is government run. It's government organized medicine. And that's exactly what Obama has wanted to foist upon the American people. And you should not be shocked if within a few years you are like an American veteran in a filthy, dirty hospital with incompetent doctors who are keeping double books and keeping you in the hallway to not treat you. If you see drug dealing in the hallways, it's going to be like a third world America right before your eyes. And whatever you say about me, just remember I told you so. Whatever you said about anyone who tried to warn you about Obama and his corrupt left-wing fanatics who have ruined this nation, we are on the road to perdition as fast as I... Okay, I'm going to stop. I know you don't want to hear it. We're approaching Memorial Day weekend, and your mind's on vacations, and there's only so much scandal overload you can take. So I think you've had all you can possibly take. So let's take a quick caller on the Savage Nation. Cynthia on WABC, go ahead, please. What's on your mind?
I have an atrocious story about the VA in New York. I have a firsthand account of how they are attempting genocide. My brother was under the VA care for cancer. He ended up with a blood clot, ended up at the VA in New York in their palliative care unit. They deprived him of water. They over-sedated him. They finally, after his 3-month stay was up and they were going to boot him out, they said they would let him stay at $1,000 a day. That we get a call that his disease suddenly progressed and he was dying. We go down there. It was clearly an overdose. They would not call a doctor. They administered me, at my insistence of my families, they administered Narcan. My brother sprung back to life. He had stopped eating. They said he couldn't swallow. They made accusations that we were forcing him to eat while he couldn't. Long story short, a week later, we transferred him to a hospice center. He is alive. He is well. He is eating.
They tried to kill him with a drug overdose to get him out of the bed?
Yes. And then the bed, yes, but it began even before, yes. And they were depriving him of water. It was so inhumane, and he had an entire...
Well, Cynthia, you shouldn't be upset because Obama has vowed to fix whatever is wrong with the VA. Just trust that our commander-in-chief is really going to get to the bottom of that, Cynthia.
Meantime, I'm watching him. He just literally ruined whatever life my brother had left.
No, I'm sorry to hear that story. It's not a pretty story, and I don't mean to make political grist out of this tragedy, but we know that Obama is the commander-in-chief, and we darn well know that if he didn't know, he should resign because he should have known. Instead of golfing and raising money and taking laughs in Hollywood, maybe he could have visited a few VA hospitals for 1/5 the time he spent raising money with Steven Spielberg. That's all there is to it. But you know, look, there's nothing new under the sun. Go back to the movie Born on the 4th of July and see how the Vietnam vets were treated back in those days when they came back from the battlefields of Vietnam. All you have to do is watch that movie all over again to know it was not fiction. It was based on reality. And I think that we're back there again under Obama. I think that's where we're going if we're not exactly back there. And I don't know how you're going to fix it with the lack of funds that we currently have. And there's only so much that any of us can possibly take, which is why we've been talking about all the other problems that are existent right now, like your vacations and where you're going on vacation and things of that nature. That brings us to 18 or so minutes after the hour on the Savage Nation. When I come back, we'll go to 855-407-282. In the meantime, go to michaelsavage.com and sign up for your free newsletter. I'll be right back.